And that's one of the things about working in the garage. There's cars that go by. Anyway, in a video I just made a little while ago, I talked about moving ahead, just keep moving, or trying to produce work even though, oh, there we are, even though I'm deeply overwhelmed by anxiety and sadness and frustration and, you know, just deep fear over the bills and the rent and everything. And not being where I want to be or being where I've worked so friggin' hard to be. And I also talked about the painting I'm working on, King Femme. It just got overwhelming and everything just started running around in my head. And so I'm putting that aside and I'm starting something new. I've taken out the two panels. Let's move this a little bit. I prepared, I think a couple weeks ago now, last week or the week before, and I found an image that I've been holding on to for a little bit that I think I'm going to work on because I need her. I need to feel this girl's strength. She projects so much strength in this portrait that was taken of her. And I don't know when it was taken, and I don't remember the name of the photographer, but I will try and track all that down like I usually do. But I found this image of a young black girl, and I love her hands and her stance and her face and having to move through, having to survive and live through an impossible time. So, oh yay, now we've got a landscaper somewhere I can hear. Anyway, noise aside, this is what I'm going to be laying out, is that particular image. What I'm running into, though, this is such a powerful image, and I believe that this girl and this image of her deserves more space to project who she is as a person or who I perceive her to be. This is what I have, and I'm grateful to have it at all. I have 2 24 by 24 canvases that I prepped. I just don't think it's large enough. This should be really a 6 foot high image, 5 foot at least. But again, this is what I have for material, so this is what I'm working with. So I'm going to stand here and sketch it out. Maybe I'll get some aerosol in, and hopefully this video will go up on the web. Hopefully the iPad can hold it so we can kind of work together again in the way that we have. I'm always band-aiding things together and trying to work just with what I have. Not thinking, okay, I'll put it off till tomorrow or next week or, well, can't even be next week, but next month maybe when I can afford more canvases. It is work with what you have, appreciate what you have. So this is what I'm doing. And again, I just don't think this is large enough to hold that young girl and all of her strength. I just don't. But we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens over the next few minutes. In the meantime, I'm going to be listening to an interview with Edie Falco on, Jesse Thorne's show on NPR, because I love Jesse Thorne and Maximum Fun. Anyway, let's get to work. Let's see what we can get done, okay? happen. Okay, so I've kind of sketched out the form and the figure in chalk. It's not written in stone, it never is. It will be umpteen million different changes while I figure this out, because I always set these up like a big puzzle and get myself confused. And now, but it's a process, and it's a process that I happen to enjoy until I don't, and then I do again. But now I'm sketching it in aerosol, and I can already see where I've gotten it wrong, just laying down the image in chalk. I know there's artists that kind of graph things out. Obviously, I don't. It's all about the feel. It's all about the feel. Am I projecting the feel of the character correctly or the image correctly? How does it feel in its layout? And that's... Somebody's mowing or something. Anyway, oh, truck just went by. By my little studio garage. And I can already see I've got the hat up. I have the hat on a little too low in one place, a little too high in others. But I'm putting in this aerosol that is going to be used to transmit color and light through the oils, which will be the next layer. But first I've got to get this laid out. And I don't really sweat it, like if I've gotten it right or wrong right away. I just don't. I put it down to the best of my understanding to start with, and then we go from there. And so that's what I'm doing. Putting down some lights and darks. And that orange, once I start to apply other colors like oranges and reds and browns on top, or even teals, will glow when the painting is completely finished, because light will go through the oil mediums, down to that layer and pop right out again if it's in the correct light or in different light. So that's what I'm doing now. Back to Edie Falco, who, by the way, just said several things that completely made sense to me. Her career really started when she was middle-aged. She was 30 or something. But, she didn't think she'd ever be an actress. So these are the little nuggets I hang on to. People who struggled and then made it. They make me feel better about life. Or about where my life is. Tilt this up. Sorry about that. There we go. think we're going to have to stop. Some of it laid out, but it's very, very, very warm in here, and I need to get a fan going because I'm inhaling aerosol, which, as we all know, is not a good idea. But I've kind of got her laid out. I'm not particularly happy with certain spots, but again, it's just adjusting, readjusting, evaluating, reevaluating. Don't work on grids. Don't ever care to. I don't trace. I just do it. I do the work, and there we are. So I've got her started. I've got a good idea where she's going to be. However, I think I have to lift both of her hands up just a bit. I made them way too elongated. But in my little setup, it's easy to make boo-boos. So we'll just adjust. Maybe her sleeve is supposed to be right down here. Because I thought... But at first I had it right, and then I thought, oh, no, I got it wrong. Let's put it up here. But I can see it's going to be readjusted. So there we are. We're going to stop for a little bit. I'm going to turn the fan on, open the door, get some air in here. And I hope that helped to get you started on your next project. Ciao.